All right, well, unfortunately, again, I was continue recording, and same thing happened, you know. There was no commentary recorded. I don't know. I guess it sometimes does it. But it is what it is, and we'll just go live with it. Because the video itself is really good. Anyways. So, I think I'm going to go back and try to get this item again. It's really tempting. It's just there waiting for me to grab. So here we go. Whoa! Do not roll. And I missed it anyway. But never roll. Unfortunately, you know, it's automatic. I mean, because in order to jump, you got to hold the circle and then hit it again. But at the same time, if you hold a circle and then double tap it, it'll roll. So it's a little tricky. You've been through this before? No, we haven't. So we're now going to a new cave. Well, it's not a new cave. I mean, it's a different cave. But there's more poison. And of course, that's being made by the poison moths. So now we're in another section of the cave. And these damn poison moths are still here. And I'm trying to find them. Where are the moths? It's not down there. Well, we lead to a dead end, so we have to go down anyway. Where is the moth? That's what I'm looking for. Where's that moth? Like any moth, they really know how to hide. Again, best not to roll when you're jumping or attempting to jump. It's not a good idea. You're not going to climb up. This is, you know, it's not going to happen. These platforms remind me of, if you ever played Guild Wars 2, they have a lot of those jumping puzzles. And that's kind of what this reminds me of, is these jumping puzzles. Like at Guild Wars 2, you have to find these, like little, narrow little steps and climb up to the top in order to get the cutscene of a viewpoint. And there's a lot of those little jumping puzzles also to try to get around the area. They're tough though. Those jumping puzzles are tough. You gotta have a really good computer in order to actually do those jumping puzzles. Well, then you'd just be inching ways to get around. So there's the bridge. Still looking at it. We're back here again. So nothing else to do but go back down. Everybody's still dead because we just lit the bonfire. We did not sit and rest at the bonfire. And here I go. Here. And I knew he was, you know. Just have to check. Everybody, if you see something sleeping or looking like they're sleeping, just kill it. Just kill it. It'll open up a whole mess. There's the moth. He's done. So it's obvious I did not go to this cave. Still looking for a moth. What am I looking for? There's nothing there. Go! Actually, I did go to this cave. I just missed that moth that was up there. I grabbed the ones that were down there, but I guess I missed him. That's weird. Alright, so what now? Well, don't want to go that way. Did that already. Yeah, stop going in circles. Let's go. Get on with it. Apparently, I'm lost. Jumping? Yeah, no, you're not jumping that way. That is a false message. It's a troll message. You don't want to jump. But he probably did, and that's why he's dead. I really have no idea what the hell I'm doing here. Okay. Yeah, everybody... we did this already. Don't you remember? Alright, so now we're going downstairs. And continuing on into the forest. So I see a guy with a torch over there. But there's somebody over here also. You can't see him because he's like dark green, also, you know, just like the tree. That's a nice camouflage he has. Then he comes with a torch. But as you can see, the torch is not is as forgiving as, you know, than before. Usually when I get hit with a torch, it will go through the shield. Now, I don't know if my shield is fire resistant. I mean, it could be. It's a tower shield, so it's possible. Some more of these guys. They like to hide. Well, nothing there. I guess I want to find out what that was. And it just boosts fire defense. So there's only... what else is to go? Across the bridge. But then we got one of the big guys over there. And of course, this is from the demo trailer that came out, I believe, last fall. That guy got in my way. Oh, the beta, I think it was. This was the beta, yeah. It sounds like my commentary is trying to get back, but it's not. So I don't know what happened, but whatever. So these guys got a big sickle. And they take a lot of stamina out of me. If I get hit with the shield. Even with the shield, it takes almost half the stamina off. So, pretty powerful. Poison ahead. Oh, this whole place is full of poison. Yeah. We know there's a moth because we just saw it. Just saw the green goo. Spraying all over the sky. He's up there somewhere. Looks like I'm looking for him. I'm ever so cautious. What the hell am I doing? Oh, look at that. Yep, look at that. And the moth just hidden right there. Well, we can't have that. He's got to go. One shot his ass. Boom. They really are just there to cause problems for those without a range attack. And you really need a balance in this game. You need to have... I mean... I guess you don't need it, but it's best to have, you know... a melee and a range attack. So if you went as a sorcerer, you have your spells. But it's good to have a sword on your hand, or a shield, something. No, a sword, yeah. Or maybe you can attack with the staff. I don't know, I really don't do sorcery. Or you could just run through it and hope you don't get poisoned. And if you do, better have a lot of poison moss. I don't know why I tried to go with an arrow with him. Oh, never mind, it's a big guy. So this time I missed the arrow shot. I'm trying to fight him melee style with full health. Using the tree as cover. And it seems to be working. Now the strategy with these guys, I think it's best to just wait for him to pound the ground and get stuck on the ground, and that's when you attack. So if you attack when he's doing this, well, you still get him, I guess. I guess he swings one wildly. But there's always a chance for the backhanded swing, so... These guys are pushovers. My sword is at a plus 5 now, so it's really strong. Oh, and I got poisoned. The moth actually got me because I wasn't paying attention. Because I forgot all about this one. Even though I saw it, like, in the beginning. But there he is, hiding in the trees. Like all little moths do. That's that. They're very weak. I mean, my bow is only a plus 2, I think, so I wouldn't know why that would, hurt them so much. So there's an item there, but we know there's somebody else is over there. Yep, I see him. Trying to get all the items, no matter the risks. Don't want to leave anything, no stone unturned. Couple good swings there. Well, it's a good thing there's poison moss around. Alright, so let's go see what this item is. What is it? Not much. Nothing worth getting. It really wasn't. It's nothing. Just a waste of time, pretty much. So somebody was able to get in there. How do you get in there? There's an item there. Probably a soul. How do you get in there? I'm so ever cautious. But this is a trap. Well, like I just said, I thought this was a trap. looks like my commentary went in and out. I don't understand what happened there. Oh, well. There's nothing else to do. I don't know what the hell I'm doing. There's an item there, but I don't think there's a way to get it right now. Or this guy died for some reason. So, heading back to the bridge. Well, this is a different bridge, actually. And we got more of these... More Hollow Men, pretty much. A lot of generic guys, pretty much, what these guys are. Oh, but there's a big guy with a freaking hammer! This guy came out of nowhere, but he's fast. This guy is fast. Want to be careful with him. I think that was the same guy that was in the swamp earlier. We did shoot him from range attacks. Just be careful with him, man. He's bad.